Welcome to Stand Up Now. We got an interesting day for you. We got some exciting guests. We got some information that could benefit your community. So let's get it started here on Stand Up Now.
Hello, everybody. We're here today with Sally, and she's the volunteer coordinator for Tree Pittsburgh. Hi, Sally. How are you?
Great. Thanks for having me.
No problem, Sally. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do, Sally, just every day?
Sure. I work for volunteer coordinating and also the membership coordinating. So I work with individuals, groups, and organizations scheduling volunteer events that we host, most of which are stewardship events consisting of planting and tree maintenance. And I also work organizing members through an individual business and group basis, too.
Can you tell us a little bit about stewardship?
Sure. Stewardship with Tree Pittsburgh is attending any of our volunteer events, which are weeding, mulching, and watering our city street trees. We take care of them for 2 years, and we look forward to community members becoming involved in their community in more than just an environmental way, but in a social aspect as well.
Is a lot of what you do local?
Yes, we work within the city of Pittsburgh, but we've also expanded recently to Allegheny County, planting city street trees and helping through the tree maintenance for the first 2 years of the city street trees.
What can young people in those areas do to get involved with this volunteer?
We have a lot of opportunities at Tree Pittsburgh for young volunteers in our stewardship program, some of which consist of volunteering for a tree care day, which is weeding, mulching, and or watering our city street trees. And those events can be small, between 5 students, to large, to about 200. We work with colleges, universities, also high schools, grade schools, middle schools. Our volunteer range is pretty wide in regards to age.
How did this organization get started, and how did you get involved with it?
It started in about 2006. It became a 501c3. Before then, it was a group of residents from Friendship that were maintaining and planting trees. Our executive director was brought on in 2006, whenever the organization became nonprofit status. And I became involved in the fall of 2008 as an intern, starting off as a program assistant, which basically included office work, secretarial work, and worked through the stewardship program, organizing all of our tree care events. And that was in 2008, and last May I was hired full-time as the volunteer and membership coordinator.
Oh, you said you became a 501c.
Right, 501c3, which is a nonprofit status. That means we do our work, we don't make any profit, and we work within the city of Pittsburgh.
Is there any higher opportunities for this, like professionally doing this volunteer work?
Definitely. We have intern programs that run throughout the summer. They start in March and they run until August. And those are usually for high school or college students that are looking for a job throughout the summer. Sometimes they start in May, too. We also have opportunity for nursery assistance. We have a tree nursery in Point Breeze. And we also have the opportunity for anyone that volunteers with us to kind of pick up a job, as we're looking for an education and outreach coordinator assistant for the summer to attend some of our summer events for us, which would be tabling and things like that. Some of the bigger events that you see throughout the city, like festivals and things like that, we like to have a presence at.
And once again, we recognize that your job is very important, and we thank you for taking time off to come talk to us. For Stand Up Now, I'm Connor.
Check out this message from Stand Up Now.
Oh, I gotta go to the bathroom.
Hey, man, that was a nice story,
bro. Take that phone real quick.
Hey, I can't take it. It's stealing.
Man, stop being a wimp. Go get the phone.
Okay, man.
Oh, bro, look, you got a camera.
Oh, that was relaxing. Hey, where did my phone go? Who's got my phone?
Hey, look at all the
yeah, remember?
Hey, that's my phone.
Hey, man, I don't want any problems.
Ow.
Don't fall for peer pressure.
Stand up now!
Welcome to the Stand Up Now show. I have a very special guest. His name is Mr. Thom Sumpter. How are you doing today, Mr. Sumpter?
Doing well.
That's good. First question I would like to ask you today is, what are the most common things that interfere with the students' learning in school?
The most common things, I would say, is having good study habits, not watching too much television, coming to school prepared to learn, and having an effective teacher in front of that student.
Oh, that's probably what I would agree with. Next question. What kinds of habits or routines are helpful to a student in making better grades?
One thing, as I mentioned before, not too much television, making sure they get enough sleep in the evening, mm-hmm. making sure when they get up in the morning that they get a good breakfast, that they're fueled for the day, and that they have the attitude of wanting to learn. So these are things that start off, and once they arrive at the school, it's up for the staff, the teachers, et cetera, the help staff to take it from there.
I have another question for you. Some kids consider dropping out of school. What kind of things or factors would make youth consider that decision?
A lot of times when kids don't feel that they're succeeding in school, that they're a failure, they're not, say if somebody gets into a classroom and their reading is behind the rest of the children, they feel embarrassed, they feel mm-hmm. challenged, they don't want to be embarrassed in front of their peers. A lot of times if they don't know the answer or haven't studied up as much as other kids have, they'll act out or they'll perform in such a way as to be disruptive but not conducive to learning, but they're doing it because of their inadequacies that they have. And because if they don't get that reinforcement in school, if they don't get the rewards, if they don't excel like other children, they'll think that that's not for them. It's a bad choice, though, in these days and times, but those are some of the factors that go into causing someone to drop out.
Can a kid get back in school if they drop out?
Yes.
They can?
Absolutely. Oh. There's nothing to prevent them from re-entering school. They might be behind their age category as far as where they should be, as far as their normal progression, but yeah, they can get back in school.
Hmm. Another question I have for you, Mr. Thom. Is the school district doing things to encourage kids to stay in school, especially youth living in unstable home environments?
The school district's doing everything it can possibly do or think or want to do to keep children in school. One of the incentives we have is the Pittsburgh Promise, which part of that is attendance. So that one of the factors that you have to be able to earn the scholarship is having a 90% attendance or greater. Those are incentives to come, the extracurricular activities as far as sports, as far as cheerleading, band, music, all of those things are in other incentives because we call them extracurricular, mm-hmm. beyond what we're the book work. And just the normal activities as far as the competition, the like I said, the sports, things like that too. And then just the interaction with other children, other folks their age, the social element helps to bring kids to school. So those are things that go on, but again, they help to keep kids in school.
I would like to thank you, Mr. Thom Sumpter. For Stand Up Now, I'm Mark Weiss.
The environment is shared by all of us, and we all want our community to be clean and healthy to live in. So consider volunteering some of your time to clean the local park, watershed, picking up litter in the neighborhood, and the planting of trees or plants. These are things you can do by yourself or with a group. And remember, you can make a difference, but together, we can make a change.
Stand up now!
Hello, peoples. My name is Kenneth Struther. I'm from Family Resources. I'm the facilitator for the Nurturing Fathers program here at the Hill District site. I just want to send a shout out to the Stand Up Now group, and I'm looking forward to seeing you guys on the 11th. Y'all have a blessed evening now.
Welcome to the Stand Up Now show. We have a special guest today, Mr. Andrew Cheeseboro from Small Seas. Hello, Mr. Cheeseboro. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you doing today?
I'm very good. So we have 5 questions for you. My first question is, what is your role with Small Seas?
My role with Small Seas, I'm the Chief Executive Officer. And in that particular role or responsibility, I oversee the operation of the program. We have like various departments at Small Seas. We have program directors. We have a fiscal area. We have a lot of our staff do a lot of case management type things. We work, the intent of, again, of Small Seas is to work with families. Some of our families are dealing with different family issues, and then some of our families are not necessarily dealing with issues. We have our program has, for example, the mother-son program is a prevention program. where the family group decision-maker program is more crisis intervention, and then our other program, NUA Ubuntu, is a crisis intervention program. So as the chief executive officer, I'm responsible for making sure that we do things right.
All right. How long has this company been in existence?
Yes. Small Seeds was started May of 1999.
What is the mother-to-son program?
The mother-to-son program is one of three programs at Small Seeds Development, Inc. The mother-to-son program is a mentoring program for single African-American moms and boys from the ages of 8 to 15. In the mother-to-son program, there are several things that we do. We focus on four or five core areas. Those areas are parenting skills for our mothers. We have a manhood training, rites of passage for our boys, financial literacy, education, and then a big component of the mother-to-son, of the mother-to-son program is health and fitness.
All right. So I got a question. If mother-to-son went away tomorrow, what would it mean for the community?
If mother-to-son program was to cease to exist and it wasn't operating, let's say, tomorrow, it would affect well over 100 families in the greater Pittsburgh area. It would mean that boys would not have mentors. It would mean that mothers would not have support groups. It would mean that siblings who are part of that family would not learn about arts and crafts and reading. And I think it would be something that would devastate the families that we work with as well as the communities that they live in.
All right. So you mentioned the rites of passage program. Could you explain a little bit about it?
Yes. The rites of passage program is a special piece of the mother-to-son program, which is primarily works with the boys from the ages of 8 to 15. There are several rites of passage programs here in the Pittsburgh area, and we are funded through the Heinz Endowment. And in the rites of passage program, we teach our boys about their culture. We teach our boys about spirituality. We teach our boys about character development. And a big part about any rites of passage is about how do I improve the quality of my life. It's not just about ceremonies. It's more about how do I make change in my life? How do I make change as it relates to my education? How do I make change as it relates to me engaging in my community? How do I make change in terms of disciplining myself, working in teams, you know, setting goals? That's what the rites of passage is about.
Thank you for your time, Mr. Andrew Cheeseboro.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
For Setup Now, I'm Isaiah.
Do you know anyone doing great things in the community that we can feature on the Sun Spotlight? Email us at standupnownetwork@gmail.com or visit us on Facebook at facebook.com/standupnownetwork. And now for our featured Art of the Day pick on the Stand Up Now show.
I dedicate this song to recession, depression, and unemployment.
Stand Up Now.
This song's for you.
Here we go.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day, but where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I'll be honest with you,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower.
When I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over, you do.
I'll smile.
Come on and
smile. It's so hard to look up when you're down. Show would hate to see you give up now.
God's people.
You look so much better when you smile. So smile.
Now every day ain't gonna be perfect, but it still don't mean today don't have purpose. Come on.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night.
It ain't easy, but
today's a new day. But tell me, where are my blue skies?
Where is that love, y'all?
Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
The truth is,
I almost gave up on a power that I can't explain.
That Holy Ghost power, y'all.
Fell from heaven like a shower now.
Now I know we've been hurt, y'all, but still,
I smile.
Come on.
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Can y'all feel that? Whatever you're in right now,
smile for me.
Smile.
Can you just smile for me?
And my people say,
oh, 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 you look so much better when you're, oh, 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 you look so much better when you're, oh, 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 you look so much better when you're, oh,
I say,
oh, you look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
And while you're waiting,
you look so much better.
Yeah, and while you're praying,
you look so much better when you're,
look in the mirror,
you look so much better when you're,
always remember,
you look so much better when you smile.
Come on.
I almost gave up,
I almost gave up,
that I can't explain,
but the Holy Ghost power, y'all,
fell from heaven,
came
like
down from heaven,
down.
Hardships, difficulties,
right now,
tears, storms, this is what I do. Boy, that feels good.
I know God is working, so I smile.
All things are working.
Even though I've been here for a while,
still,
I smile. Smile.
Hallelujah.
It's so hard to look up when you've been down.
I know it's hard right now.
Sure would hate to see you give up now.
Because you're a winner.
You look so much better when you smile.
You look better.
So smile. Oh, oh, oh.
Dallas.
You look so much better when you're home.
New Orleans.
You look so much better when you're home.
You to be happy, but then you gotta have something happen then. I want you to have joy. Oh, this game's about to make that country. I see you.
I'm Sheila B. with the University of Pittsburgh on my other hat, and you're here with the Family Support Picnic. Everybody's having a great time. This is our annual day just to celebrate, bring the kids together. We're glad Mr. Bay and Stand Up Now is with us. I'm a mess from running and sweating, but it's all in fun.
With so much going on in the communities, have you ever wondered what's on people's minds?
Who do you think's better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
I think it's Lil Wayne.
Any specific reason, or you just like him better?
I like him better.
Who do you think's better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
Lil Wayne. He's been in the game for more years, and he's better at going freestyle.
Who do you think's better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
I prefer Eminem because he's been at it a longer time.
Who do you think's better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
Lil Wayne. He's been in the game for a long time, and he knows a lot of stuff about the game, so I pick Lil Wayne because it's my favorite artist.
Who do you think is better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
None of them. Why is it? Because I'm a Christian and I don't listen to rappers like that.
Who do you think is better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
Lil Wayne because he raps about his life.
Who do you think is better, Lil Wayne or Eminem?
I prefer Eminem because he's more lyrical.
In the community, we often find an individual that goes unnoticed. Yet the knowledge they share and the work they do truly makes a difference in the community where they live or work. Sean Coleman is one of these community stars. As a kid, Sean had a stuttering and anger problem that caused him to be picked on as a youth. Deciding he needed a positive outlet and answers to overcome his personal problems, Sean began his life journey. Now as an adult and college graduate, when he is not working that 9-to-5 job, he teaches life coaching and anger management at Perspective Inc., a business he started with his wife.
Hey, my name is Sean Coleman, giving a shout out to the Stand Up Now Network.
To perform on the Stand Up Now show, send requests by email to standupnownetwork@gmail.com or visit us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/standupnownetwork.
Thank you for tuning in for the Stand Up Now show. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook at Stand Up Now Network. And remember, you make a difference, but together we make change.
Stand up now.